How's it going, everybody? I'm IGP, and welcome back to Subnautica. In today's episode, we're going to begin adding homes into our IG paradise. I want to first thank everyone who commented and left their requests. Your interaction is insane, and your support is amazing. For those of you who are just now joining us, I have asked you guys to leave a comment in the previous video called Let's Build Together, and tell me what kind of home you would like in the IG paradise, and I will add it to it. So if you haven't done it already, be sure to do that. I'll put a link in the description to that video. I will only be taking requests through comments in the comment section of that video. And also, I was presented with the idea that once completed, or once I find a good stopping place, I can try to make this public for download. And I will give you guys instructions on how to install it, so that way you guys can load up the game and look at everything yourself. Now, if there will arise any issues with that, and if you know about it, please let me know in the comment section below so I can address those and make sure it all goes through smoothly. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump right into this. We're going to be doing these from the oldest comments to the newest ones. That seems to be the most fair. So the first one is from ZipZop. He says, I just want the nearest house near yours and call it Zip's house. Just make sure it has an aquarium full of peepers and you have to catch all of them. Ha ha ha. Well, fantastic. Let's go ahead and do that. Now, I'm assuming you meant this old house. This was my old house and you might want this one. But I moved my house over to this giant tower, the all-seeing tower, so I would just add a new one for you. Now, since you are the first person to leave a request, I'm going to give you a special moon pool that is going to be your Seamoth docking station that actually connects underneath this particular island. And check this out. I was originally going to take this for myself because I thought it looked amazing, but look at this. You can actually come in, and I might terraform this out a little bit wider at some point to make it easier for you to do that. Now, I don't want to mess this up. So before we do anything, I'm going to go ahead and save again. So that way I'm right here and I can just load it back up. So let's add the moon pool as the Seamoth garage here. Seems appropriate. An underwater garage. That just terraformed a hell of a lot out of there. Did not mean for that to happen. But hey, this is your home now. So here it is. It kind of works here. I might have to terraform and add a little bit of dirt around this. I kind of wanted it enclosed, but hey, this is what we're looking at here. Hopefully it's not too ugly for you, you know? But you'll come through here once I terraform that out, park your little thing here, and then over here. Now this is gonna be cool looking. It's actually partly under it here. Let's take a look and see how this looks. Now we have to add an aquarium with a bunch of peepers, and I have to catch them all. So you wanted this called Zip's house. Let's do that real quick. Zip's house. Whoop whoop. Oh, it actually hovers. Look at that. All right, so let's go ahead and add the aquarium. This is what you wanted, and we'll add it here. And you want a bunch of peepers that I have to catch, right? Great. Oh, look what happened! I wonder where these guys came from. I better catch them, though. That's part of the request, right? Where's the other one? There it is. Come on. All right. So I caught a bunch of peepers. Let's add them to the aquarium. All right, so Zip's house, yours is complete. Here we are. The entrance to Zip's house. You got your own garage that's going to be terraformed out eventually. I'll do that. I'll get back to that eventually. That'll be a project, a list of projects I'll make. But here is the first house. Thank you, Zip. All right, so the next one is from New Link. It says, can you call one Link and have it a glass everything and put whatever you like in it? But back to what it looks like, two rooms together with glass halls to put them together, please? Yes, I will do that for you. Unless you specifically ask for a location, I'm just gonna go ahead and add you closest to the tower and then keep on going. All right, so we want two rooms together with a glass corridor connecting them. So let's go ahead and do that. Where's the glass corridor? Here we go. Now, I want to stick you out this way, I feel like. All right, so I have the glass corridor here, and then the room is going to connect to that, like so. There we are. So we got a floating room here. Now, you said anything goes in this, so that's fine. We're going to go ahead and name it. Now, we should add some bulkheads to everyone's home. That's definitely something we should be doing, so that way, you know, in case anything happens where something floods, a Reaper comes attacks, because I'm definitely going to be spawning some Reapers. All right, and we're going to be calling this Link, and then there you go. Awesome. So this is Link's house, and we can put whatever we want in it. I think I'm going to do a little bit of decorating. Why not? Let's put a bench down here for people to sit. Let's put an aquarium in the corner here. That looks neat. And then in the next room we're going to connect here. This looks awesome. I like this idea. And you did want glass everything, so let's go ahead and add that real quick. Windows everywhere. Now, because we're adding glass everywhere and not reinforcements, I might have to take some reinforcements and put them somewhere. Not necessarily on your home or anyone's specific home, but we have to add it somewhere. Because now this is all connected, so anything I put on here can be adjusted elsewhere. Now bear with me, as we add more stuff, the game is going to take a bit to load. You can see how it's a little bit jumpy here. At a certain point, I'm going to have to reduce the frame rate to make it a little bit more smooth. And as you can see, as we look out here to basically nothing, we get a good 60 frames here. So, at a certain point, I'm sorry guys, if the quality of the video, or rather, the frames of the video kind of spike here and there. But this is Link's house. This is what we're gonna do, and I'll add a few more things. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and add a workbench over here to decorate your home a little bit. You can do whatever you want with it. Fabricator can be right on the window, because that's attractive. And then a specimen analyzer can be in the corner over here. And then a fragment analyzer could be in the corner over here. Bam. That looks cool. And I actually want to do something. Go ahead and give you some TV. Because everybody needs TV, right? Everyone needs to be able to watch some TV. We're going to go ahead and add a dish to your home. Now you can watch television. Actually, never mind. I totally forgot. I just powered up the place. Let's add some more of that, actually. Dude, that is cool. The bone shark is like right above the rays. That's awesome. Alright, so we got power now in our... let's put that better. Alright, so that is house number 2 by New Link, called Link. This is what we're looking at here. It actually looks kind of pretty. I enjoy it. And we got a little bit of solar power going on. You can make a bunch of stuff if you want, since you told me to decorate it. Again, I hope you enjoy. Eventually, you guys will be able to explore this place, and that'd be awesome. Alright, so let's move on to the next one by Amaleki Mlanek. I'm sorry if I mispronounced that. I probably butchered that. 2 glass windows, the rest is reinforced. And on one end, put a locker, a fish tank, anywhere, and 2 benches, and call it Rapture. Maybe even add an observatory on my house. Okay, so we're gonna do 1 room, which is cool, because this one is kind of right there. We're gonna leave this right here. I hope you guys are enjoying the locations I'm putting. These were already built, so I might as well make use of them. Let's go ahead and go in here. Now, you want 2 windows. 2 glass windows. Let's go down. This is how you get to your home. Let's add a bulkhead first, because we're gonna need that. All right, so 2 windows. I'm thinking like this. And you want the rest reinforcements. Let's do that real quick. But you do want an observatory, so I'm gonna try to add that out to the edge here. Let's add the name to it first real quick. You wanted it called Rapture. I can definitely do that. I'm assuming that's a reference to BioShock, as people are saying. All right, so we got your observatory over here. It's close to the edge. You can kind of look off and see all the amazing glory that is the base. There's a bridge over to the other island here. All right, so we want to put lockers. Now, I don't know if you wanted a wall locker or not, so I'm just going to go ahead and put a wall locker here, and then a stand-up locker on the other side for you, if you want to go ahead and, you know, place a bunch of stuff in there. And I'm going to go ahead and give you some items. Let me give you some... let's give you 5 diamond, huh? Let's move that diamond over. You get 5 diamond. Congratulations. 2 benches. I'll put 1 right here for seating and viewing pleasure. Bam. And here we go. Awesome. So that's the 3rd house here, Rapture. Hope you guys are enjoying this. Hope you like what you see. We're looking at here some benches. If we want, we can sit and relax and just look around. Isn't this nice? Welcome to my home. So that's Rapture. Let's go ahead and move on to the next one by Rex Sal. A glass room with fish tanks and a bench in the middle and maybe 1 observatory. The Sea Tank TST. Okay, I can do that. And then we actually have to travel from all the way back here. It might be a little bit more convenient for me to add something like a 3-way right here. Because then we can add another home too, if we really want to. There we go, out like that. And then we can add a hatch right here as an entrance to your home if you want. Now, we're gonna add the bulkhead, as usual. Alright, so we're gonna call yours again, what? The Sea Tank TST. The Sea Tank TST. Awesome. Put it over here. Increase the size, so we all know. Awesome. This is what we're looking at here. Oh, whoa, I totally forgot I added this. Well, this is what you're gonna be connected to, because you're awesome. So let's add another bulkhead over here. Now, you wanted this all glass, so we'll do that. Let's, in fact, get rid of this hatch that we don't need. So we added all glass here. I'm gonna put the observatory on this side when I get outside. But I also am going to add your bench request right in the middle. There we are. And then you wanted a fish tank, so I'm gonna put that over here behind you. And I'm gonna give you 2 peepers, huh? Look at that. That's gorgeous. Let's see what your observatory can look at. Pretty much everything. That's a nice little island. You can see down here, this is gonna be your corridor. Now, I kinda wanted to separate this, but I think this is pretty good if we have you connected to the long thing here. Now, I imagine people have to pass through your house to do this, but that's fine, right? You could be the gatekeeper. All right, so that's the next one. Let's add a few more today. The next one is from Mr. Minecraft. 2 rooms tall, 1 room at the back, which is gonna be the kitchen, with a moon pool at the back over the edge of the island, like a Seamoth garage, and call it Zion House. By the way, love the vids. Thank you! So if I understand this correctly, I'm just gonna put 2 rooms here. Actually, as a matter of fact, I'm going to add a curve over here, and then add your two rooms around this nice little thing right here. Okay, so we got that here. That's awesome. So we have an entryway to both homes, and you said you wanted a garage that is going to come out on the side here, which I might be able to do with a moon pool. Let's see how this would look. Now, I just saw rocks fall off this island. Why are rocks falling off? Is that normal? How come I've never seen that before? Okay, so this is the best that I could do for you, because anything else is going to obstruct the neighbors, and I don't want to do that. So here you are. You're actually going to be docking your sea moth onto the first floor of your thing here. So we're going to get up, look it up here, and I think we can add a bulkhead here. Can we not? No, we cannot. Okay, so this is going to be your first floor. We'll have them connected again with a ladder. Straight down to the second floor. And out to the regular hallway. Here's where we add the bulkhead for your front door. And you wanted this called Zion House. I will definitely do that. 1 second here. Zion House. Bam, 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 bam. Awesome. So now we got this. And you wanted a kitchen somewhere. Now I'm thinking... trying to think of a good place for your kitchen. All right, so we're gonna call your kitchen this observatory. This is gonna be your little kitchen here. It's gonna come right over here, and that's where you can do your cooking with a bunch of open glass windows. That's what we're doing. Let's add a satellite dish. You can watch some television if you wanna. Also give the base power, that's the point. All right, so this is the Zion House. Now, this is kind of undecorated, so I'm gonna add a few things here. Let's go ahead and add a normal bench. You wanna sit down and watch TV or something crazy? Watch everyone go up the ladder. Put a locker over here. All right, so this is your kitchen. Here's your stove, here's your refrigerator. It's not really in the most optimal spots, but hey, it'll work, right? And then we'll put this here as your countertop, is what we'll call it. There's your kitchen. awesome. So that's another one done. Let's do one more for this video real quick. And this one is by 77 Miller Productions. They want to call it Philip. It's going to be two buildings, four floors each, separated by a four-long glass corridor at the bottom floor, with an observatory overlooking the deep ocean. And the top story only has windows in the observatory, a fish tank at the very bottom. Great. So, 517 meters deep from which location? We're just going to add a bunch of vertical connectors and get you down there somehow. So I'm thinking maybe you want four long glass corridors. So I'm going to split you off right here, actually. And again, let's go ahead and save so we don't mess anything up. Four floors each, okay? It's a little overambitious, but we're going to do it. Now, what I was thinking is you want 517 meters deep on the very bottom. Okay, and top stories only have windows in the observatory. A fish tank on the very bottom. So I'm not sure exactly what you wanted, but I figured I'd compromise. Here's the beginning, and here's what we'll do here. We shall do a corridor like this, and then vertical connectors all the way down for 517 meters. If that's really what you want, we will do it. So let's go ahead and add this real quick. Actually, well, before that, we'll do the observatory you said you wanted, which is going to be right here, overlooking the deep ocean. And we'll go ahead and terraform this out so you can actually see that. Bam. It's kind of the deep ocean. You're looking at a wall, but hey, this is what we have to do. Now we're going to go ahead and go all the way down with this one. This is actually kind of a neat idea. And this looks pretty cool going down right now. I think we're about to cut into the mountain here. Might not be the best thing. Okay, here we go. Yeah, it's just only barely cutting through it. We're going to get there eventually. I'm surprised this is stable enough right now. It's taking away one per unit that I'm putting down for the integrity. Well, not really one, about 0.6. Which can add up, and it is adding up, but we'll add some reinforcements to the one down here. Now, it's kind of interesting how it, you know, it's an instant teleporting. So if I'm at the top of this, it's going to basically put me all the way down here. It's going to be fun. Now, I'm going to put it in the same direction that we kind of went, outwards. So we might actually have a room inside of the mountain, which would be pretty cool. All right, well, I kind of totally lost track of what I was doing. I went actually farther than normal, but we're here. And I'm going to go ahead and call it right there. Yep, okay. So we're going to add a little corridor. Now, we're in the mountains. Sorry about that. There's not actually that much I can do. Actually, I need to get away from here. Be able to make a hatch underneath here so I can get up inside. And then what we're going to do, woo, is add a ladder. God, hold on. Oh, man, it's lagging bad. Hold on, guys. It's a little terrible right now. You have a lot of stuff going on. The game has been open for a while, and it seems to actually slow down for me as the game is open for a while, but it might be because of this long structure. So the room needs to be over here, and about four stories high, they said. I can't do it. I gotta terraform a bit. Hold on. It's fine, because it'll terraform out anyway. Let's add that, and four. Okay, so that's it. What else did you want? You wanted, all right, so the top stories of each of these, they want windows, which is not really gonna do you any good here, bud. And you want a fish tank in the observatory. That's doable, definitely. Let me try to get past this ladder glitch here. Good lord. Okay, so again, we're running a little bit low in frames. I might have to reduce the frame rate here to make it a little bit more smooth for you. But since he gave us permission to, I'm gonna add some reinforcements, since we're not gonna be doing anything down here, because that took up a lot of, you know, a lot of stuff. Oh man, the lag. All right, so that's what it looks. You can actually see the little, the ladder up there. Yeah, it definitely is lagging when I look at that thing. So hopefully, maybe we can do something about that. I wish I could just teleport. That'd be better. At a certain point, I might actually have to get rid of this. So it's gonna be here for now. All right, so let's add a bulkhead to the beginning like we usually do. All right, so what did we name it here? Philip. Okay, I'll just do Philip's house. Let's do Philip's house. Phillips house. Bam. Increase over here. Awesome. Okay, so Phillips house. Yours is not done yet. We have to add the ladders real quick. Up to the top floors. And one last thing. What a fish tank to your observatory. Awesome. Okay, so we're done with Phillips house. Again, we go down 517 meters. That is totally lagging up. All right, so this is what we've got so far. It is definitely slowing down like crazy. We've added a lot. It actually looks a little bit more compact and more like a city to me. Again, I apologize for the frame rate right now. This is pretty bad. But here you go, this is what we're doing. And there's your house. Philip 77 Miller Productions. Goes all the way down to 517 meters deep. And that's what we're looking at. So, hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Again, if you haven't requested a home, please go to the link in the description to the original video and leave a comment. I'm doing them in order of the oldest comments to the newest ones, so if you do comment now at this point, it's going to be much later when you'll see your house being built, but eventually you will see it. I hope you guys enjoy this. If you do, you know what to do. Like, share, favorite, and subscribe if you haven't already. I love you all, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye! Woo!